Let's start Chapter 15, Time of Emergency. Have you ever experienced an earthquake? Have you ever faced a landslide? Have you ever faced a flood or any other natural calamity? Has anyone you know been affected by any kind of natural calamity or emergency? Emergency is a crisis situation which occurs suddenly without any warning. Emergency situations can include accidents, bomb scares at shopping malls, stampedes, or any other condition caused by a natural calamity such as flood, earthquake, cyclone, tsunami, and the likes. Natural disasters. Natural disasters can cause a lot of loss to both property and life. Many people lose their homes and everything else in the face of a natural disaster. The natural disasters cannot be prevented. We can prepare to some extent against them. But first, we need to understand the different natural disasters. Earthquakes. Earthquakes happen when there is a movement in the tectonic plates of the earth. It causes the shaking of the earth's surface. Earthquakes below 2.0 cannot be felt by us, whereas earthquakes above 5.0 can cause serious damage. Fabulous fact. The strongest earthquake ever recorded was in Chile on May 22, 1960. This was measured to be 9.5 on the Richter scale. Tsunami. When an earthquake happens under the sea, it causes a series of huge waves. These waves travel at the rate of 450 miles per hour and rise very high to cause great destruction on the surface of Earth. Floods. Floods are caused by overflowing rivers. When there is heavy rainfall, the rivers get flooded, spewing their water onto their banks. This water submerges entire villages and destroys the crops totally. Landslide. Landslides are caused when large amounts of earth, rock, and other materials move down a steep slope. A landslide can block rivers and can even bury towns under it. Cyclones. Cyclones are large winds blowing in a spiral around a center. Cyclones that form over warm oceans are called tropical cyclones. In the Atlantic Ocean, these cyclones are called hurricanes, and in the Pacific Ocean, these are called typhoons. The swift winds often bring heavy rainfall and destruction to the coastlines. Snowstorms. Snowstorms feature low temperatures, strong winds, and large quantities of snow. Particularly strong snowstorms are also called blizzards. Precautions and help during emergencies. Though natural disasters cannot be avoided, one can be prepared for such emergencies, especially if one stays in areas that are prone to such disasters. Here are some things that we can do in the face of natural calamities. Keep all emergency numbers handy, including the numbers of hospitals, police, fire brigade, ambulance, chemist, and the likes. Listen regularly to radio and television, as warnings against cyclones, hurricanes, and tsunamis are generally related over these. On hearing any flood or other warnings, move our belongings to somewhere higher. Stay away from water bodies and electrical poles. During an earthquake, one must either run out of the house in an open area or take cover under strong, heavy furniture. During times of emergency, the governments as well as the local people, along with some non-governmental organizations, help the people affected. These provide support in terms of shelter, medical aid, food, clothes, articles of daily use, and medicines. This kind of work is known as relief work. Relief camps are set up in places undergoing emergency situations. These camps are organized and managed by relief workers who work either privately or with the government. People who are forced to leave their home due to natural calamities or due to war take temporary refuge in camps. Some camps are called refugee camps. Fabulous fact. Some NGOs that are regularly engaged in relief work all over the globe are Red Cross, WHO, UNICEF, and UNESCO. Often in areas where a natural calamity strikes, all lines of communication are cut. Roads are lost and there is no way to reach the people. In these cases, the people are not able to reach the relief camps set up. In such conditions, men from the Army and the National Cadet Corps, NCC, are sent to rescue people. all public amenities play an important role during times of emergencies. It is important to make people reach hospitals so that they can be given first aid at the earliest. This is done by the ambulance service of the city, and till they arrive, it is the duty of the police to make the people reach the hospital safely. First aid. Immediate relief or help given to a sick or injured person before he reaches the doctors is called first aid. It is important to learn some basic first aid steps in order to be able to help somebody in problem. First of all, a first aid kit should be made and kept with you. A first aid kit should contain the following: sterile gauze pads of different sizes, adhesive tape, bandages in different sizes, scissors, cotton, antibiotic ointment, soap, antiseptic solution, painkillers, tweezers, sanitizer, cold packs, safety pins, gloves, flashlight, all emergency numbers, and a blanket. Once the first aid kit is ready, it should be kept at a place where it can be easily located. Secondly, it should be checked regularly to ensure that no medicines exceeding their expiry dates are kept in the first aid box. Here are some things that you must know. You should administer first aid only with the help of an adult. Here are some first aid steps that you should be aware of. In the case of a fracture, ensure that the fractured part is not moved. Create a support for the person by placing a magazine or a pillow near the fractured part. Do not in any case move or lift the fractured part. Sprains occur when the muscles tear. Wrap ice cubes in a towel or a cloth and apply to the sprained area. After that, the sprained area should be bandaged tightly and made to rest. If a person gets burned, then the burned area should be kept under running cold water for about 15 to 20 minutes. The burn should be covered with a clean cloth in order to avoid infection. Blisters should neither be broken nor touched. A cut or a wound should be cleaned with an antiseptic soap and then covered with a clean cloth or bandage. In the case of a nosebleed, make the patient sit on a chair with his head back. Cover his nose with a clean cloth to catch any blood that drops. We should always follow some basic rules of safety in order to avoid accidents or even small injuries. Revision time. Emergency is a crisis situation which occurs suddenly without any warning. Emergency situations can include accidents, bomb scares at shopping malls, stampedes, or any other condition caused by a natural calamity such as a flood, earthquake, cyclone, tsunami, and the likes. Earthquakes happen when there is a movement in the tectonic plates of the earth. When an earthquake happens under the sea, it causes a series of huge waves. This is called a tsunami. Floods are caused when overflowing rivers spew their water onto their banks. Landslides are caused when large amounts of earth, rock, and other material moves down a steep slope. Cyclones are large winds blowing in a spiral around a center. Snowstorms feature low temperature, strong winds, and large quantities of snow. During times of emergency, the governments as well as the local people along with some non-governmental organizations help the people affected. All public amenities play an important role during times of emergencies. A first aid kit should be prepared and kept handy for emergency situations. One should know basic first aid.